Ninny Noonday Ninny. Ninny Noonday Ninny is whatever she is and goes wherever she goes.
Her arms are nylon jumping rope.
Her breath smells like falling snow.
Ninny was nervous and never content.
If only I was the Noonday Country Cross Stitch Queen. What is fire made of? What are minerals made of?
What are minerals?
I would be prettier with freckles. She preferred her garden and never left home.
She smiled when the bees raced to the daisies
on sunny afternoons and grinned when the earthworms displayed their innocent affections
at night.
Last summer, she invited the insects and birds from the garden to a late dinner. She served a healthy selection of fresh fruit and tender grains garnished with last year's rye seeds. The crow chicks were punctual.
The grackles were casually late, but forgivable in their angel sea top hats.
And shy parrots disguised themselves as sweet tomatoes and sour cherries. During their pleasant night of gabbing and nibbling,
Ninny and her party were shaken by the roaring arrival of an uninvited guest.
The honeybees were shooed from their daisies, and the worms driven from their quaking tunnels into the moonlight to huddle, quivering in damp grass.
The bragging specter called itself,
"My flowers are much bigger than yours,"
appeared, aiming infected reminders of puddle drowning, hive collapse, and other bully bother directly at Ninny and her guests. Through a sleepless night, the damning visage continued with a mocking smile
and hideous permanent grins
before her guests dismissed themselves politely to an apologizing hostess. Still kneeling in the dirt, Ninny planted a ripe rye seed in honor of the fictional visions of a false future it brought them.
The seed sprouted into a full-grown tree by fall. Ninny quickly took residence in its summit to examine the curve of the crummy earth. She perched happily like a maker dreaming another impossible world. She watched swarms of
sprint like veins of custard through the whipped cream of anyone's boring reality.
Then out the other side, like an arrow flung at the perfect crystal in the world's most hideous engagement ring, but missing intentionally.
Ninny purred in the comfortable vastness of the vision.
Sunbeams crowded to illuminate her meditation, luring swarms of moths with its radiance. How could one cute girl have imagined this much beauty?
It was
then that she decided to never climb back down. She could stay as high as she wanted and watch the world twitch and fidget far off and below.
Ninny says,
"You know where I is, but nothing I knows.